Hey guys, Chef Nyesha Arringon here, and we are talking the beloved English muffin. We are going to make them from scratch with all of the nooks and all of the crannies. Order of operation. Let's get our yeast blooming, which needs to feed, right, to create those nooks and create those beautiful crannies. The yeast needs a little bit of time to almost ferment in that warm milk. So we're just gonna pour the yeast in, set that aside. I'm going to dump the AP flour in, and a little bit of kosher salt goes in the bowl as well, and lots of love, of course. Let's get this yeast in here. Mixy, mixy, mixy. Do a little shimmy while it's mixing. Let's go, English muffin dough. So the dough should look kind of shaggy. You want this sort of shaggy style dough, because that's ultimately gonna give us the best nooks and crannies. Okie dokie. So you wanna knead the dough for about 8 to 10 minutes, and it'll be a little bit sticky at first, which is okay. And when we're kneading, very important to kind of pull out away from you, because that's what's gonna give us these beautiful nooks and crannies. So I'm just kind of pushing out and away and tucking and folding. Okay, so now that we have our English muffin dough, what we're going to do is allow this dough to rest so beautifully in this beautiful glass bowl here. So, good night, little English muffin dough. We'll miss you. Take a little nappy poo, rest. Get your life together. I'm going to let this rest for about 12 hours in the refrigerator. I like a good slow ferment, is definitely my jam. So I'm going to place just a nice light linen napkin over the top and just allow this to develop flavor and texture. So we're gonna get into portioning this dough. Definitely want to cut down the dough into equal portions. To shape the dough, we don't want too much flour on the work surface. Actually, just do a light dusting, just so that the flour can get just a little bit into the crevices and the grooves. And from here, really what I want to do is sort of wrap the dough in and on itself to create a nice, uniform, smooth outer surface. We want to enclose the bottom and use this portion of the hand to shape the dough. So it will tighten up over time, and you can feel that. So you're kind of using your fingers to coax under the dough and bring it up, and it should be kind of perky. Oh my God, they're little buddies. We definitely want to punch in and capture all of that beautiful air and fermentation, because as these rise once more, we'll start to see those air bubbles and pockets. I like to use a mixture of both semolina and cornmeal. So I get that beautiful sort of crunch and texture from the cornmeal, and then just a light dusting of the semolina so that it doesn't stick to the pan. I'm not trying to go for this like perfect round English muffin. It's gonna taste exactly the same no matter what shape it is. But for sake of breakfast sandwich purposes, we will make them round. So just a nice little light flat surface. And then I'll just sort of tap them into that cornmeal and then just allow them to proof once more. Gotta be really patient with these. This is not something that's gonna happen right away. Okay, little babies, time to take another little siesta. I will cover you and tuck you in. We're making gribiche sauce. Gribiche sauce is one of my favorite sauces. I love the way a gribiche sauce tastes on a breakfast sandwich. So I like to use a mixture of chives, tarragon, and parsley. And then I just give them a rough chop. I love shallots so much. Mise en place, slicing the pickles. And I like to use sort of equal parts capers to pickles. Capers, welcome to the party. Capers meet cornichons. I will add some Dijon mustard. I love a good Dijon forward aioli. Vinegar, a little bit of yolk, call it 2 egg yolks. This is gonna be the base for our sauce. And from there, we'll start to emulsify or slowly drizzle in a fat. In this case, we're using grapeseed oil, cayenne pepper into our aioli. I'm gonna add in my chopped capers, my sliced cornichons, and shallots here. Great. So chopped egg. You know how to chop an egg. Don't need to overthink it. I love the jammy yolk like this. And that is going to go into our sauce base. It's done, easy. English muffin time. Ta-da! So happy, they look great. Thanks for taking a little nap. And so now we want to get our pan a little bit hot because we want that sort of classic crispy texture around the outside. And then what I'm going to do is finish these English muffins in the oven. But I really am taking the time to carefully remove these from the pan. I do not want to destroy one tiny bubble. We want to preserve all of those bubbles because then that translates into the nooks and also the crannies. Chefing it up. Let's check these babies. Got some color going. Very, very important to, I love to use a great griddle or a cast iron pan. I would not suggest using like stainless steel. You're not gonna get a really beautiful, even heat distribution, a beautiful, even heat, coloration. Stainless steel pans are great for like sauteing and quick cooking, but cast iron pans is just an amazing sort of all-purpose pan that has a very even cooktop surface. Great, okay, so I'm putting these English muffins in the oven. Look at them, just look at them. I'm gonna open this guy up. Steamy. We have the English muffins. Toasted this for the most ultimate breakfast sandwich. Yeah, I mean, I'm really stoked, mostly about the aroma that's coming off of these English muffins. Really phenomenal. And it's so empowering to be able to make something that, you know, generally, I imagine a lot of people are buying their English muffins, but you know, there's very few ingredients to make these, you know? And these have been such an amazing childhood favorite. So to bring them to life is absolutely amazing. We got the little nooks, the little crannies in there. Let the assembly commence. So I love these little pockets in here that hold the butter and hold, you know, jam. You could use cheese, ham, hash browns. That's what I'm going to do. But you know what, there's nothing better than a sort of heavily toasted English muffin with great butter, amazing Maldon sea salt, some awesome strawberry jam or grape jam, whatever you see fit. But I love a toasted English muffin, and these little nooks, I mean, they're in there to capture those little bubbles and pockets of butter. Oh my gosh, and scene. We have the most beautiful English muffin, followed by some delicious Canadian bacon and some delicious melty cheese, then a sunny side up egg. I love to put hash browns on breakfast sandwiches. I just think you're like one stop shop, breakfast, go, right? And then the most awesome gribiche sauce. Yes, I'm going for it. Oh my gosh. The texture of the English muffin is impeccable, very tender. This egg yolk is like moisturizing the entire sandwich. Awesome gribiche sauce, cannot get enough of this. I hope that you make this sandwich at home. I mean, I'm very happy. This is a one-stop shop. You got your hash browns, you got your egg, all in one concealed. This is what you do. You wake up in the morning, you say you're hungry, you hop up out your bed, you make your little sandwich, wrap it up, make it to go, and take it with you, right? Easy. Enjoy.